brave princess did eat a giant crab. Long ago, a giant crab lived in a deep hole at the bottom of the sea. Twice a day, it would crawl out to search for food. As it left its home, the hole would fill up with water. Since the crab was so large, it took all of the sea along the shore to fill up the hole. As the crab finished eating, it crawled back into its hole. The water was forced back out, causing it to put high up on the shore. Someone told his tide of the day, high tide and low tide. One evening, a princess was walking along the shore, looking at the sea. Suddenly, she saw an island rise up from the sea and start walking toward the shore. That isn't an island, that is the giant crab. The crab was higher than the island's highest tree or mountain. Then the princess saw the crab's giant pincers and eyes. The crab was looking at the moon as it rose up. The princess watched the crab open its pincers and tried to pinch it and bite the moon. Its red eyes followed the moon as it climbed higher. Then the crab reached out and tried to grab it. Snap, snap. The crab grabbed its pincers. They look like sodden. If the crab touched the moon and ate it, the evening sky would be dark forever. The princess knew her people was at a feast. People was dancing and having fun. No one would see the crab until it's too late. She needs help to stop the crab from eating the moon. Suddenly, the princess had an idea. She found an empty crab shell, put it to her lip and blow. A large noise came out.
Coming through.
The princess watched the crab's giant pincers get closer and closer to the moon. Snap, snap, snap. She brought in the shell again and again. The crab's pincers get closer and closer to the moon. The princess brought again, still with the largest breath yet. As the sound died out, the drums start beating. The princess looked toward the village and saw a line of torch come toward her. The waving line of the torch looked like a large snake came along the mountainside on the way to the beach. She brought the shower again and ran toward her people. Warriors from what?
Armed with swords,
knives and spears appeared. As they looked at their eyes, show fierce as they looked perhaps the largest crab they have ever seen. She it grabbed at the moon. Her pincers reached higher than before and almost touching the moon. But the moon slipped from the pin from the crab's grab.
Great.
And the crab fell on her back, its back. The princess catched a spear, and ran to where the crab was trying up.
Trying to get up.
She ran up a side of the crab. She aimed its spear at the crab's soft belly and stabbed it. Every warriors do the same while dodging the pinchers. A warrior cut off one of the pinchers and the other pinchers was cut off. Soon the crab was dead and the moon was saved. The bravery of the princess saved the moon. The night sky still lit by the moon. Ship can sail by the light of the moon. The water of the sea still go from high tide to low tide and back again. People say that is the pool of the moon that casts these tides, but islanders say that the water still flowing in and out of the crab's home at the bottom of the sea.
How